There's a French proverb that says, one pleasure, a thousand pains. This played out through Oscar Wilde's life as it was lived decadently and ended in suffering. The 1800s saw many new advancements, both in technology and in philosophy. For example, aestheticism. Aestheticism is an intellectual and artistic movement emphasizing beauty. It states that being beautiful is inspirational enough on its own and that art shouldn't express a deep meaning beyond beauty. One of the most memorable aesthetes that the world has ever seen was Oscar Wilde. Oscar was born in Dublin, Ireland on the 16th of October, 1854, with the full name of Oscar Fingal O'Flahertie Wills Wilde. His family was well known in social circles. His father, Sir William Wilde, was a successful surgeon, and his mother was a literary hostess who wrote poetry under the pen name Speranza. Because of his popular family, the young Oscar Wilde was constantly in contact and socializing with people at his mother's events. It was there that he began gaining his characteristic charisma and charm. He was an intellectual by nature, and he was brought up as such. He had five siblings, but he connected particularly with his sister Isola. She died suddenly when Oscar was 12, and this tragic childhood loss haunted him for all his life. Up to the age of 9, he was educated at home by a German governess and a French nurse who taught him French and German. This started him off as an impressive linguist from a young age. The first school he attended was the Portora School. This is where he adopted his interest in the classics, specifically Greek and Roman. He graduated from Portora in 1871 with a prize for being the best classics student in his last 2 years there, as well as a scholarship to Trinity College, Dublin. He quickly became top of his class studying classics. His classic professor was John P. Mahaffey, who inspired Oscar to love all things Greek. Around 1783, Oscar began his interest in the aesthetic theories, publishing an essay called Aesthetic Morality. He then moved from Ireland to England to study at Magdalen College, Oxford. His professors here had a very strong impact on his ideals. He was notably taught by John Ruskin and Walter Pater, who both impressed on him the importance of art in life. Pater was particularly important in Oscar's college years, telling his students to burn always with hard, gem-like flame, an expression that would come to be famously representative of the aesthetic movement. Oscar began to adopt trends of the aesthetes, decorating with peacock feathers and blue china. This was also the time when Oscar began establishing himself as a poet, winning awards for the lengthy poem Ravenna. After his graduation in 1878, he briefly came back to Dublin. His father had died peacefully but bankrupt, and his mother sold their house for a substantial profit. With his portion of the money, Oscar moved to London and lived with portraitist Frank Miles, who was popular within London's high circle. In 1881, Oscar published his first complete book entitled Poems, a compilation of poetry. It was met with mixed opinions and was less popular in England than it was in America. The most repetitive criticism was that it was too derivative of the work of other poets. A quote by Oliver Eaton stated, "Mr. Wilde may be aesthetic, but he is not original." In late 1881, Oscar left England and started on a lecture tour across America and Canada. He arrived in New York on the 2nd of January, 1882. The string of lectures was originally only going to take place over 4 months, but due to his huge success, they were extended just shy of a year. Throughout this time, he blended with all kinds and classes of people. He drank with coal miners, as well as went to high-end salons with relevant people such as Walt Whitman. Oscar was very appreciative of America, and the people of America were fascinated by him in turn. When he returned to England, he left for another lecture circuit across England and Ireland. In 1884, he married Constance Lloyd, a wealthy member of London's upper class. They had two children, Cyril and Vivian. In 1886, there was a turning point moment. Oscar was seduced by Robbie Ross, the son of a well-known Canadian politician, and Robbie became Oscar's first male lover and is often credited with introducing Oscar to what was then the undercover gay scene of 1800s London. In 1887, Oscar found a job as the editor of a popular magazine about women's fashion called Ladies' World. It was around this time that he began publishing substantial works, such as The Happy Prince and Other Tales, and The Decay of Lying. In July of 1889, he left his job to focus on writing a novel. This novel first appeared in the press in 1890. This book was the picture of Dorian Gray. The original editor deleted nearly 500 words and accused it of having too many themes of decadence and homosexual allusions. Yet, Oscar defended it and had it published again in 1891. It is said that the main character of the novel is based on John Gray, a poet and a member of Oscar's inner circle. From 1892 to 1893, Oscar began to publish plays, which were all very popular and skyrocketed him into being hugely famous. In 1891, the same year of the official book publication of The Picture of Dorian Gray, Oscar was introduced to Lord Alfred Douglas, nicknamed Bosie. Bosie was in his early 20s, beautiful and spoiled, the son of the wealthy Marquess of Queensbury. Bosie was prone to mood swings and pretentious behavior, constantly leaving Oscar hanging whenever he was needed. Yet Oscar was very in love with him. They quickly began an affair, and Bosie was without a doubt the love of Oscar's life, but he was also his downfall. Bosie's father was known in society for being notoriously angry, aggressive, and unpleasant, and most of Oscar's close friends and acquaintances advised Oscar to stop being so close to Bosie. The Marquess fiercely opposed the relationship, leaving his calling card at Oscar's club inscribed, "For Oscar Wilde, posing sodomite," on the 18th of February, 1895. The card was intended to say, "For Oscar Wilde, posing as a sodomite," but either out of illiteracy or anger, history will always remember his misspelling of the word sodomite. Oscar, against all reason but at the urgings of Bosie, filed a lawsuit against the Marquess for libel. It was a bold choice to sue someone for libel when they weren't lying, and it became clear soon enough that Oscar was losing the lawsuit. He tried to pull back, but the Marquess had escalated the lawsuit from a libel case to a criminal suit to jail Oscar for being gay. Oscar had written many letters to Bosie that were obviously romantic in nature, and he had about 12 male lovers by this time. Though Oscar made quite a few moving remarks on the nature of love, in 1895 he was sent to jail and was transferred to several different jails before staying for the majority of his sentence at Reading Jail. He was sentenced to 2 years hard labor on the charge of gross indecency. While Oscar was in jail, he wrote a 50,000-word letter to Bosie entitled De Profundis, which translates to From the Depths. In prison, he punctured an eardrum, resulting in an infection. After he was released in 1897, he immediately moved to France. His wife refused to let him see his children, and she sent him 3 pence a week as his income. He lived in a hotel, poor and ill. He met with Bosie after he was released, and they lived together for 3 months until they separated. It's been said that they weren't happy away from each other, but they weren't happy when they were together either. Oscar's health progressively worsened, and his last two loyal friends were Robbie Ross and Reginald Turner. On the 30th of November 1900, Oscar Wilde died. His accredited last words were a variation of, "Either this wallpaper goes, or I do."